Did it not save my data? At all? Oh, okay. Nope, oh, there's alright, there's the save menu. Come on, let me look at the save menu, please. Please! Save menu! Continue! Woo! Alright, that's right, I'm back. I've been well rested, and it's time to continue milk outside a bag of milk outside a bag of milk outside a bag of milk. I don't remember exactly what I was doing. I think I was looking for fireflies, but I don't, like, I don't, are the fireflies still here? I have no idea. Are you joking? Even though it's my room, not everything here is for me to use. Whatever. I don't care. Yeah, I don't care at all. Like, totally, and I'm definitely not worried. Not even a little spit. Not even a smidgen of the little spit. Not even for a thousandth of a percent. That's how much I don't care. Dot dot dot. Hey, I'm not even done telling you how much I don't care. This one went on. I'm ignoring you. Oh, no, you don't. Then act normal. Yeah, act normal. God, but. What's this say? Your usual notebook pages glued to the wall with duct tape. Numbers are drawn on them. It's the only kind of information I can take in without trouble. Dosage and side effects? Yeah. I thought you know them by heart. Yeah. This isn't your handwriting, is it? Of course it's not. Shaky, broken lines. Oh, wait, no, but that's a narrator, I guess. Wait, it's like there's me, and then there's her, and then there's somebody thinking. Shaken, broken lines, ugly numbers. It's not writing, it's more like claw marks. Don't forget to thank your mom right there, bro. I don't need your advice. My screen makes the- oh, okay, so it's her thinking, talking, sure. My screen makes the pages rustle restlessly. After a moment, a firefly appears from underneath one of them. Oh, so I am still looking for the fireflies. After looking around in a business-like manner, it takes off into a business-like flight and ends up entering my business-like ear. So business-like. Hey! Let's continue searching. That's not my type of beat. Oh, hell nah. I should've just left it on the first song. There we go. Think vaguely relaxing. What's funny about that? I imagine myself being a firefly that's looking straight at the giant fan. And? I'd be so jealous! The only thing preventing it from flying is the cage it's locked in. And the cable. It's like an inmate, if you think about it. It's so sad, that poor fan, oh no! Why do you have two radios? Ooh, okay! I can't go inside, can I? Have you checked your backpack? I look down, my school bag worn down and silly. Is almost screaming of its own uselessness. From another angle, it looks like a full belly. Its contents are also regurgitating, decomposing, and turning into a sticky, mushy substance. Did you leave your lunch in there? What a cool image. I need to remember this. Yeah, totally not cool. Oh no, wait, is there like something- why was the sentence in cruel line there? Tell me what's inside your bag.
Nothing special, mostly just all sorts of books. I've taken out all the pens and notebooks out of there, and I'm not interested in anything else.
We used to go to school, didn't you?
Yeah, I did. I had a blast all the way.
Are you sure you understood my question?
Do you think everything in my life should be doom and gloom? Well, you're wrong.
Alright. What did you like the most there?
Well, the rooms were really bright, not like at home.
That's it?
Don't rush me. Let me remember. Well, the beds were all so soft. And the food was nice. By the way, I attended all the classes. The others always skipped. They probably got told off so hard.
I smiled gently, absorbed in warm memories. You never graduated, though.
Yeah.
Do you remember your last say there?
It was a normal day. Dad picked me up earlier than usual. He told me that I'm already too old for the school curriculum. I also realized that some time ago. The tasks were way too easy. Then we got into the car and went home. Mom greeted us there and we ate dinner and went to our rooms.
And what happened then?
I don't remember. It doesn't even matter.
Okay, I will not push!
Good. I look at my bag again, light pouring into the room through the window glints on the metal parts. There's also a shadow underneath it, which means it's real. Sadly. Whatever, I don't care anyway. I almost ended up kicking the bag in a fit of sudden anger, but I managed to stop myself in the nick of time. If I move it even an inch, the whole picture will collapse and I'll go blind. It has already happened countless times.
What do you mean you'll go blind?
I spent months memorizing the location of every item in my room. That's why I can see them so clearly and vividly. You won't get it.
Look at your feet!
I look down and see that a small insect is crawling toward me from my bag. It's barely glowing and it can't even fly. I guess this firefly is really tired. I bend down to pick it up.
I'm being very consistent with these voices. I'm sorry. I'm out of it, man. I feel well rested, but this game just makes me tired. The firefly starts glowing brightly as soon as I touch it, and then flies up. I'm gonna use my normal voice for the narrator. Thoughts?
There you go, boy. Good job.
After doing a victory lap around the room, it flies towards me with high speed. I shut my eyes, anticipating the firefly to enter my ear. That's exactly what happens. After it gets inside, it buzzes for a little while, then goes silent. I could not take this up, bro. If I hear him buzzing in my ear, I'm running.
This one is kind of sad.
I wonder why.
Doesn't matter. What matters is that it's no longer alone.
Sure. Let's continue searching. How many are there? Oh my god. Oh, thank god. Ah! Finish searching! Okay. I finished to gather my thoughts, but something still worries me. On the other hand, I wasn't supposed to be happy anyway. Why not?
If I lose something and then find it, it's just going back to the starting point. No changes at all. A zero sum. And happiness is always about being positive, right?
You shouldn't think too much. It hurts you.
I want to sleep.
How about you get some fresh air before sleeping?
What do you mean?
Your door's open. Can't you... Alright. Nah, go to the balcony. Breathe in some air. Stare off the edge. Oh, yep.
Somehow, this word triggered a panic attack in me. I subconsciously step away from the balcony. I don't think it's a good idea.
Why?
This may sound silly, but... I feel like someone is watching me.
Alright, let's stay here then.
Yeah.
What are you going to do?
What's with this silly question? I'm going to sleep, of course. Hoping that tomorrow will only come after a year, or a decade. Imagining myself to be outside of my mortal shell, but at the same time still being me. Ridiculous, like milk outside a bag of milk, and yet...
And yet?
You don't have to talk out loud for me to understand that you're worried about me. I know that already. I also know that our time is running short.
What? Are you dying? You won't take another pill.
Of course not. In fact, I won't take it tomorrow either. And the day after tomorrow. And never ever.
That's a goodbye then? What am I just like the medicated voice in her head?
No. I have one more small favor to ask. A really, really small one.
What is it?
I've blurted out way too much today. A lot of stuff I wanted to forget forever. I don't blame you, but was it really necessary?
You'll see tomorrow.
No, I wouldn't be able to sleep like this.
Fine, what's the favor?
I
nervously scratch my wrists and bite on my lower lip. Wait a minute. You're afraid to tell me?
Yes! I'm also scared that something bad might happen if I tell you. I'm also scared that when something bad happens, something way worse will happen.
Stop, I get it already. Still, I won't leave you alone until you tell me.
Bully?
No, you!
I crawl into my sleeping bag. The lower part of the room is very cold. I hurry to wrap myself in blankets, even though the electric heater is working hard to keep me warm. I'm sad because the dreams just won't come anymore. You won't believe me if I tell you how I dealt with it at first.
Of course I'll believe you. I know.
It was a joke. Well, anyway, I washed my face, brushed my teeth, lied down, and started imagining that I'm watching a dream. I didn't sleep at all, of course, and always looked sleepy in the morning. After a week of insomnia, I started feeling weird and seeing things. Letters floating in the air, strange silhouettes that appeared in the most unexpected of places, bulging eyes with trembling pale pupils. It was scary, you know? Then one day I almost died. I just collapsed in the middle of the room and couldn't move for a while. And then silhouettes, letters, and eyes were hanging over me and hissing. It was horrible. And, well, deserved, I guess. I felt like I was caught on the biggest lie in the world. Yes, I felt exactly like that. After that, I stopped. But the silhouettes, letters, and eyes stayed here. I guess they like this place. They always follow in my wake, peeping at me. And I'm kind of scared of them. I can't even argue with them. But today... Today...
Well?
I...
Still too scared to tell me?
Of course! They're still listening, you know?
Use your hands.
Alright.
I start chaotically twirling my fingers with enthusiasm, forming complex shapes. You want me to... tell you a bedtime story?
Shh! And I was trying so hard here! Don't you get it? They'll hear you!
Relax, nobody can hear you.
So, what do you say?
I'd be happy to, but I've no idea how to tell them.
Oh, it's incredibly easy. Just talk about something without stopping.
Sounds silly.
But it's not.
And meaningless.
You don't know what you're talking about.
I know enough to realize that we'll end up just wasting time. Let's focus on something actually important.
Boring.
Why can't I tell her bedtime story? Come on!
Fine.
Close your eyes. Ah! I don't- Oh my god! No! I don't want to go into the darkness!
I wake up on a wooden bench. In front of me lies a narrow, dimly lit alley. An awfully familiar road. Where could I have seen it?
Oh, finally! I don't know who this is! Oh! Whoa! Who is that dude? Sorry. Yep, see? The yawning! I don't know. It's coming out of nowhere again.
I hear a voice coming from the side. I turn around and see a boy with a weird expression on his face.
You're late.
Who are you?
The boy blinks in bewilderment. We're not going anywhere like this. Try again.
Then he takes a very deep breath.
You are late.
I stare at him, confused. He stares back, also confused. Sorry?
The boy nods, satisfied. See? Much better. Do you have a name? My name's Treska.
I give the brat an evaluating look. He's so young, yet already coming at me with questions like that. None of your business. And besides, will anyone tell me what I'm doing here?
Hey, that's rude. It's like there's somebody else here besides me. Haven't they told you anything? I know all there is to know, for one.
About what?
You're obligated to escort me to the store. Triska says that it strikes a victory pose!
No way I'm doing that.
You do understand that refusal is futile? What? This brat's spitting big words out!
Well, aren't you a fool of yourself?
Is his face getting closer or am I imagining it?
I'm not the one who decided that. Do you think I'm delighted with your company? He's weird, constantly shifting between happiness, sadness, loudness, silence. He's a wacko, and his name is Stupid.
Are we going or what?
You can go, and I need to think.
I'd be happy to, but I don't know the way.
Treska puts on a cunning smile. I bite my lower lip in frustration. I'll be honest with you. I don't like you. He simply bursts out laughing in reply. I do like you, though. Then he grabs my hand with hesitation. I don't even have time to retort. Lead the way. Our trip to the store went fine, if not for the fact that Trusk was walking way faster than me.
Why does he walk like that?
And on the other hand, at times he stopped abruptly and went backwards, studying the ground underneath his feet. In the end, the trip took a lot longer than it should. After reaching the store's doors, we were greeted by a sign. We're closing in 20 minutes!
Who had the bright idea to indicate their working hours in this way?
They probably have special staff for this. Someone who wants to change a sign every 5 minutes. It's convenient!
No, it's not!
Are you joking?
Yeah.
You're so annoying. It's much better than being boring. How old are you, by the way?
None of your business.
And what's your name?
None of your business!
I was ready to slap the living hell out of the brat, but a scary-looking man suddenly appeared behind the glass. He's holding a cardboard sign that says, "We're closing in 15 minutes! Let's go. What are you waiting for?" Huh? Oh, yeah. After another round of going across the long row of canned products, we realized that we're lost.
I can't believe you don't know where they sell milk. Maybe we should ask somebody for directions?
Sure.
Hey, wait up!
Triska lets go of my hand and walks confidently towards one of the few store's customers. That person is standing with her back to us, studying something on the shelf. Hello, can I? I can't hear neither the second part of his question, nor the reply he gets. But my good-for-nothing friend freezes in place, looking the customer straight in the eye. I hurry towards them.
Is he yours?
The customer talks to me. He speaks with disgust while wearing a scornful expression.
If he's yours, please get him away from me.
Yes, I'm sorry. I grab Triska's hand and lead him away. He's still looking at the customer, his mouth ajar and his eyes popped. He's also shaking. Only when we turn around the corner, Triska calms down.
What was that?
I got so scared, he said.
What?
No, not again! Suddenly, Triska starts screaming like crazy. I cover his mouth with my hand. His face is burning. He's crying.
Can you act normal?
You don't understand.
Of course I don't. I don't understand anything. Annoying other people is still wrong, though. This is something you don't understand, it seems.
You're mean.
Who? Me?
Triska pushes me away and runs off.
Rat.
At the edge of my vision, I see the store staff handing his hang a new sign on the door.
There you are.
I meet Triska at the cash register. Before that, I managed to visit the milk department after finding out where it was.
Hey, you, move!
I hear an angry voice coming from the other side of a long queue that is formed after Triska. I squeeze through towards him.
What happened?
The boy doesn't respond. He just looks at his feet and sniffs. The cashier towers over him. There's a bag of milk lying between them.
Is he yours?
Yes.
Just leave him home next time.
People in the queue.
Nod in agreement!
Pay for the goods, please.
Yes, of course.
And the waiting fee.
What?
You heard me.
I did, but that's unheard of.
Triska starts giggling all of a sudden.
And for the fact that your son is a too!
But...
You heard me.
You know what?
In a fit of rage, I throw a banknote to the cashier, of much higher value than needed, even counting in all the stupid fees. Then grab a milk and turn around on my heels.
We're leaving, Triska.
We spend the whole trip back in silence. At some point, we end up turning right towards a gas station. There, Petruska finally breaks the silence. Do you like ice cream? No? Okay. I look at the boy's face. Light flickers in his eyes for a brief moment, and then goes out. You know. He turns away from the path and walks straight towards the highway with determination. I stare at his back, confused. Is he gonna jump? Seems like you're not helping me at all. A new playful light flickers in Treska's eyes.
Uh-oh! Oh, no, I thought we were gonna see him just, like, jump in the rope, bruh.
Was this like someone Milk actually knew? Who died?
Oh shit!
That moon. Wait. Oh my god, I did it! I beat it!
Well then, I don't know, I'm pretty tired. I don't want to go through and try to 100% this, but that was milk outside a bag of milk outside a bag of milk outside a bag of milk.
Yeah, well, hope you enjoyed that. That went by kind of quick. Man, I could have finished it on like one episode unless I wasn't so tired.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the comment button.